The iconic James Webb Telescope has finally turned on its camera. The $10 billion telescope would still take months to begin its journey, as it has to cool down and undergo weeks of calibration work to ensure that the 18 segments of the main mirror work as one. NASA revealed its first target after the Webb Telescope reached its final orbit, which is at the second Lagrange point. This is an area of balance between gravitational forces of the Earth and the Sun. The first target of the James Webb Telescope is a Sun-like star in the constellation of Great Bear. This target is just to check if the mirrors are properly aligned. NASA confirmed its large antenna had been turned on, and the first star it will see is HD 84406. This high-gain antenna allows the telescope to send images and data back to Earth. It was an important step required before the calibration could begin. HD 84406 is a Sun-like star near the Big Dipper, which is about 260 light-years away from Earth. The star has a surface temperature of about 5,000 Kelvin, which is about 8,540 degrees Fahrenheit. This star is about 4.4 times the size of the Sun and 11 times more luminous than our Sun. It could actually be part of a binary star, according to data from the Gaia telescope. Once the telescope is in focus, the star will be too bright for the telescope to study. But it is a perfect target for the telescope to gather engineering data and start its mirror alignment. This star will help the telescope to align its 18 honeycomb-shaped mirrors. The telescope will keep staring at this star while optics experts move the mirror segments in small steps to create a perfectly smooth surface. To align the telescope's mirrors, engineers will take 18 separate out-of-focus images of this star using each of its mirrors. A supercomputer will then determine exactly how each image must be oriented to bring the telescope into focus. This work is expected to last until late April. The first proper images will probably be released in late June or early July. These images will be taken by the telescope's most crucial camera, which is the near-infrared camera. The near-infrared camera will cover the infrared wavelength range from 0.6 to 5 microns. The camera has to first cool down to its operational temperature of -244 degrees Fahrenheit. It will take weeks for the instruments to reach their operational temperatures. For mid-infrared instrument, this temperature is only 10 degrees Fahrenheit above absolute zero. The spectrographs can operate at slightly warmer temperatures of -393 degrees Fahrenheit. These extremely low temperatures are the key for Webb Telescope to be able to perform its scientific tasks. The telescope was designed to image the oldest stars and galaxies that formed in the universe in the first millions of years after the Big Bang. But because of the expansion of the universe, the light emitted by these galaxies is only visible in infrared wavelengths. Since infrared light is essentially heat, the dim signal wouldn't be noticeable if the telescope itself radiated any warmth. While the telescope's camera will produce stunning images of stars and galaxies, the spectrograph will provide detailed information about the chemical composition of those distant objects. It will be able to detect light from the earliest stars and galaxies and the population of stars in nearby galaxies. It is also equipped with coronagraphs, which allow astronomers to take pictures of very faint objects around a central bright object, like star systems. Compared to its 30-year-old predecessor, the James Webb Telescope has the ability to see objects 9 times fainter than Hubble could. This allows the James Webb Telescope to see further back in time. It isn't a direct comparison though, as the Hubble telescope was more of a visible light observatory, whereas the James Webb Telescope looks in the infrared. The telescope's goal is to survey potentially habitable exoplanets and some of the most distant and oldest objects in the observable universe. This telescope will make it possible to get precise observations of alien worlds. This will allow scientists to understand the nature of their atmospheres and learn more about how atmospheres work in general. The James Webb Telescope launched after a decade of delays. The $10 billion mission, dreamed up by astronomers in the early 1990s, pushed the limits of what's technically possible. Once its mirrors are aligned and instruments calibrated, the telescope is expected to revolutionize many areas of astronomy.